Boom. What is going on, guys? Financial Dan here. It's pretty late at the hotel room right now. It's already almost 11 o'clock. I'm going to make this a quick video. We're going to talk about making passive income off your crypto, making your money work for you. That's what the rich do. So you should too. Let's dive into it. So first off, not really shown here before I get into the crypto side of things, I just kind of wanted to reiterate a fact that if you work for a company that has a 401k that does a matching, that's kind of partly free money. And, you know, aside from crypto investments and whatnot, it is a great idea to just match whatever your employer does with a 401k. The remaining of that, most people put into savings. Everyone talks about putting into a savings account and always putting into a savings and whatnot, and then forgetting about it, you know? And, you know, that was pretty good back in the day doing that. I had savings account when you put into a high interest savings account where you make interest on your savings. And it used to be, you know, anywhere from 4%, high ones were 5%. And then it kind of went to around 2%. And most recently, with the way the government stands and where the banks are right now, take a look what you got. You got 0.5%. Some of the highest you can kind of get, 0.56 is what they're considering a high yield savings account right now. You know, I still have an Ally savings account, and I've actually withdrawn the majority of it. I think I left a couple $100 in there to put into other investments, looking at stocks, looking at crypto. And the reason being why crypto could be a good option is because of, look at here, this is on Voyager. And if you just hold USDC, which is pegged to the dollar, 1-to-1, you get a 9% APR. And all you have to hold is $100 on the Voyager app. Link down below in the description. But I'm not a financial advisor. This is educational research purposes. And I'm going to explain the risks of this here in just a second. Because you might think, well, damn, from 0.5% all the way to 9% just with USDC, which is just the digital equivalent of a dollar. So I just deposit $100 onto Voyager and exchange it into $100 of USDC, and I'm making 9% APR, like, why not? And then even you might even do a quick search, and you'll see on an article or somewhere that your USD is FDIC insured. Our customers insured up to 250,000. Then you're really thinking, well, damn, I mean, I might as well. I'm up insured up to 250,000. But you have to be careful. This is USD, not USDC. USD is just money held in your Voyager account that's not deposited into any crypto. By law, regulations, and whatnot, the FDIC is unable to insure any cryptocurrencies, no matter what exchange you're on. So anything that's backing up USDC is from the exchange themselves. Hey, if this video is bringing you some good info, please like, please subscribe. Appreciate it. Now, Voyager is very reputable. They're getting really big, and they've got lots of altcoins and whatnot. And I like to think that they, too, back up, you know, the event of a possibility of a hack on the exchange, which the security on these things is insane, the amount of research and everything they do. It is a very high amount, but it's still a possibility. Now, Coinbase as well offers 4% APY in USDC. And once again, as well, Coinbase has statements saying that, you know, they're not covered by Federal Deposit of Insurance Corporation, FDIC, because it's a crypto. It can't. And they also have a, you know, statement saying that our policy does not. So they say they'll cover any crime insurance that protects a portion of digital assets held across our storage system against losses from theft. So if they get hacked, they'll get you some money back, or your all your money back. But they do mention that that's just if they get hacked. If your password, your username gets leaked or you lose it or something, or your app itself gets hacked, then that's your loss. They're not going to cover you. They've got a disclaimer right here. And I mean, in a similar sense, this is very similar to a bank account. I mean, if you gave your PIN number to someone on the street and dropped your debit card, you don't think, you know, it'd be easy for them to go and steal your money? It's somewhat a similar situation. And so there's an article here about, well, you know, Coinbase is 4%, so it's a little bit less than Voyager. Are they backing it more? Like, how risky is theirs? And once again, you know, here this article from Motley Fool talks about how since USDC isn't legal tender, it's not going to be insured by the US government. So, however, issuers of Center's USDC stablecoin are regulated and licensed financial institutions that are required to report their reserves every month, ensuring that each USDC is truly backed by one US dollar. So that would go for both Voyager and for Coinbase. The second biggest risk with USDC is that it is hosted on the Ethereum blockchain. And therefore, if the blockchain itself gets fully hacked with a 51% attack, in which attackers can then fake addresses and double certain transactions and whatnot, and basically move things around that don't make sense, then it could be a possibility that your money could be taken away. However, a 51% attack, especially the more as time goes on with Ethereum being a proof of stake and more validators and whatnot happening in the network, it just gets more and more and more difficult. At this point in time with Ethereum size and how diversified it is, it would be incredibly difficult for a 51% attack on the blockchain. Biggest risk in crypto, honestly, is passwords, scams. Especially scams is a big one. You might even see in the comments in a lot of my videos, there's tons of people commenting WhatsApp numbers and to contact me and blah, blah, blah. Please don't follow through with any of their requests or anything. It's all scams. To summarize, my point of view on this is, one, I like to be diversified across exchanges. So I've got, if you've noticed, multiple affiliate links. I'm not gonna lie, you know, they're in my description and it helps me out if you sign up for them and deposit in them. But regardless, it helps to have a lot of exchanges, because then you're more diversified across exchanges. And if, especially if an exchange goes down for whatever reason and you're wanting to buy a certain dip, then you've got options elsewhere. So check out the links in my bio. There's all sorts of benefits you can get with each one. And honestly, the rewards are worth it. Free $100 here, free, you know, 10% down here and whatnot. Check them out. So this is just, you know, a bit of a video here just on giving you some smart kind of passive income savings advice. I do believe that USDC is a safe investment as long as you protect your passwords. You know, definitely set up two-factor authorization on all your exchange apps. And then I write down my passwords physically rather than saving them on any notes or photos on your phone. And I take the paper and I lock it in a safe. And that way I know that all those are stored there. If I need it, I'll go back there and I'll go get it so that I can retrieve it. Especially all like my wallet phrases, recovery phrases, all those types of things. Don't store those on your phone, because your phone can be hacked. There's screen recording apps, there's keyword. They can see what you type sometimes if they hack into it. You know, I get it that newer iPhones and newer phones and what that, they boast a lot of high security features, but I mean, these hackers are getting smarter too, so you never really know. But I hope this was some interesting stuff for you. And if you don't mind, like, subscribe. And we'll be coming up with more crypto, more passive income, more stock, more financial advice. All right, guys, talk to you later.